Here we are, we're very near Hotel Chatham, and I've just walked along the beach to the immediate east, and we've got this lovely, interesting rock. It's got quite a story to tell. If we look closely at this rock, we can see these very conspicuous white bits. These are fossil shells, and would you believe they're 50 million years old? And what they're telling us is that these shells got buried within sediments on the sea floor way back then. Most of these larger fossils are actually bits of fossil oyster, but occasionally there are fossil scallops, and there's an awful lot of skeletal material relating to bryozoans. It's a colonial marine animals, and they look a bit like corals, but they're not corals. So for instance, some of these, they come in sticks and clumps, and they're distinctive because they have a lot of little holes. See, there's a lovely branching bryozoan with a lot of tiny wee pores or holes. This is a fossil barnacle plate. You can see some echinoderm spines. I didn't mention sea urchins or kinna, but there are plenty of those in here as well. It's a little clam, actually, and it's beautifully preserved. So this is an oyster, a much bigger shell, and you can see it's quite lumpy and irregular. These sorts of elongate shapes may well be a fossil sponge. Here's a part of a crinoid, and crinoids are sea stars. We don't see them very often. And notice how everything is fragmented. So these are bits that have been transported or redeposited. So they would have lived upslope, and they've been swept down by catastrophic seafloor processes. So we can see all sorts of features here. I suspect these are trace fossils relating to organisms that burrowed through the sediment on the seafloor, leaving a very distinctive trail. So these sorts of trace fossils are the product of worms, crustaceans like shrimps and crabs, and also echinoderms. There are lots of sea urchins that burrow through the sediment and leave a very distinctive trail. So fossils are immensely powerful in terms of enabling us to interpret the nature of the environment in which they thrived within the sea. So they tell us the age, they tell us something about water temperature and hence climate, and they tell us something about water depth. And I can tell you that these rocks accumulated in water depths of between 100 and 200 meters. But the really interesting thing about this particular rock is, for all that it's a sedimentary rock, it's entirely made up of fragments of volcanic rock. So it's actually a volcanic sediment.
Okay, so here's a lovely example of a piece of basalt. So this volcano is a basalt volcano. So the lava has erupted and it's cooled on the seafloor to form solid basalt, and then it's subsequently been entrained within the sediment.
How do we find the volcano? Well, here's a clue. We can actually see the layers, the stratification in the rock, is actually sloping off to the east. So perhaps the volcano is off to the west. Turns out it's not far off, so let's go and have a look in this direction. So this place is called the Lookout on Tikitiki Hill, and we're just a few hundred meters away from where we've just been, and we're overlooking Petrie Bay, and I'm looking down on the beach here, and lo and behold, got the same sedimentary rocks that we've just observed. Now, what's interesting about these sediments is that they're going in the opposite direction to the slope, the gentle slope that we just observed just to the east of the hotel. So somewhere between here and the hotel must be the center of the volcano. Oh, here we are on the top. This is Tikitiki Hill. And guess what? There are volcanic rocks here. This is solid basalt, and if you look closely, you can see evidence of quenching, rapid quenching. And what you can see is lots of little gas bubbles, but right next to it is this
but without gas bubbles, and that would have been the chilled margin or skin, and that would have been up against the water. So that's what this is. And you can see curving shapes here and there in this rock, suggestive of pillow lavas, and they are unique. They only form in water.
So this is lava that cooled on the seafloor. This is the top of this little submarine volcano that we've been exploring. Tikitiki Volcano. Well, here we are back where we started. We've now established that we've got a volcano here called the Tikitiki Volcano, submarine volcano, and it's about 50 million years, remember? And here we can see different colours on top of the volcanic rocks associated with the old volcano, the submarine volcano. And the darker layer, it's actually a fossil soil. And above that is a very bright white layer. And that's really interesting. And I'll tell you more about that in a moment. But the key thing at this point is that we have terrestrial sediments resting directly on marine sediments. And guess what? There's about 50 million years between them. So this fossil soil is probably only about 50,000 years old. And the bright white, we know, is 25,500. Here is that bright white layer. And guess what? This is a volcanic ash. But not submarine. This is a subaerial ash layer. In other words, it accumulated on land from the air. And this is the Oruanui ash. And this erupted, would you believe, from Taupo in the middle of the North Island of New Zealand. And here it is in the Chathams. And this ash is very widespread. We can find it all over the Chatham Islands. Really is amazing. And it's a testimony to the power of nature to think that we can have an eruption in the middle of the North Island and we can bury the Chathams. Quite remarkable. And of course, since then, 25,500 years ago, we've had a soil profile develop on top. That's the story.